In this section of a factory, there is a bottle filling machine that fills the empty bottles on a conveyor belt with liquid from this tank. In this and the next lessons, you're going to learn how this machine works and how to write a professional PLC program that fully controls this machine. The components that I have for this machine include input devices and output devices. The machine inputs include these momentary switches that I have here, this three-position selector switch here, and these three photo eye sensors. For the purpose of controlling this machine by a PLC, these components are going to be wired to the PLC input module. The machine outputs include the conveyor belt motor, the drain valve, and these two signal lamps here, which are all going to be wired to the PLC output module. As you can see, this filling machine has three operation modes, which are off, manual, and automatic. These modes are determined by the three-position selector switch here. When I put the switch in the manual state, the machine is going to operate in the manual mode. And when I put the switch in the automatic state, the machine is going to operate in the automatic mode. To be able to write a proper PLC program for this machine, I need to know how exactly this machine operates. So let's see how it works. When the machine is in the manual mode and this switch is pressed, the motor rotates in the clockwise direction. As soon as I release the switch, the motor stops. If I press the next switch, the motor rotates in the counterclockwise direction and stops when I release the switch. When this switch is pressed, the drain valve is going to be open, and when I take my hand off the switch, the valve will close. So that's how the machine operates in the manual mode. Now let's see how it's going to operate in the automatic mode. In the automatic mode, when the start switch is pressed, the motor rotates in the clockwise direction. When a bottle is seen in front of the sensor number 2, the motor is going to stop, and this valve will open for 7 seconds. After 7 seconds, the valve is going to close, and the motor will start rotating in the clockwise direction. This process continues until I press the stop switch, at which time the whole system will shut down. I have two additional photo eye sensors at the two ends of the conveyor belt. Sensor number 1 is going to be used to count the number of the empty bottles on the conveyor belt, and sensor number 3 is going to be used to count the number of the filled bottles. There is also a reset switch here. This switch is going to be used to reset the number of the bottles counted by the sensors at the two ends of the conveyor belt. This means the empty and filled bottles counted by the sensors will be set to 0 when I press this switch once. As you can see, I have two signal lamps here as well. These lamps are used to indicate whether the machine is in manual or automatic mode. The man lamp will be lit in manual mode, and the auto lamp when in automatic mode. Neither lamp will be lit when in the off mode. Okay, now you're completely clear about how the machine should operate in both manual and automatic modes. But there are a few safety points that I need to take care of while I'm writing a PLC program for this machine.